We are live at Pace Studio today with Gavin Turek.
Yay!
And she's going to play a few songs for us, or sing a few songs, I should say. And Gavin, will you tell us about the first one?
Yes, it's called On the Line, and it's the first song off of my EP, track number one. So, yeah, this is it. Seems like everybody's changing now. See the writing on the wall. But the truth.
So you have an EP coming out tomorrow.
Yes.
Yeah, tomorrow's
good
the day.
Good Look for You. Tomorrow's
it's called
release
Good Look
day.
For You.
Yes.
Right. How did you arrive at that title?
Well, I wrote a song called Good Look For You. And then when we were putting the final tracks together, I just thought that that would be an appropriate title. It's very confident. It's a very, it just kind of encapsulates what, how I'm feeling right now and just the mood of the EP, which is just very confident and sweet. And yeah, I just like that title.
Great. Great. Will you tell us about the next song you're going to sing?
Yes. The next song is called Good Look For You.
All right. So,
very appropriate.
Good lead-in.
Cool. If you're watching live, you can dance with me. In your house, at your job, wherever you are. Tell me, does it really matter what your mama says? Tell me life can get much better when we lock and stare. I've got you wrapped around my finger and I know it can help but show it. I'll take you places that you've only seen in dreams. No stopping us, babe. Not gonna run away like those other ones. 'Cause if you're dealing, then I'm willing help you to make your mind.
Got this feeling,
got this feeling,
got the answers to you.
I'm a good look for you.
Fun.
Yay.
So I mean your style and your dancing and the your aesthetic, your singing, it feels very pulled from a sort of long lost era.
Yay.
And yes. You know, we definitely get some Donna Summer vibes, Tina Turner vibes.
My favorite.
Who did you grow up listening to, admiring?
Donna Summer, Tina Turner. Diana Ross was a big one in my house. Yeah, gosh, all of those amazing, phenomenal goddesses. I just really latched onto as a little kid. I think I just was obsessed with their personas. And even though I went through my phases of liking certain genres of music, I always came back to that just feel-good, soulful, disco-influenced vibe. I love to dance. It's just innate in my body. I always want to move. I'm not even moving as much as I usually do today, but yeah, I just kind of became obsessed with that feeling. I think I associate music and creating music and listening to music a lot with like getting a certain feeling, and that feeling for me is just happiness and an escapism. So that's what I hope to give to people. Yeah.
Well, you absolutely do.
Thank you.
Will you tell us about the last song you're going to play?
Yes. It's called The Distance, and it's my emo song. You should be here with me, giving me what I need. Won't you come closer? I can't wait that much longer. If you could only see how you're affecting me. Wish I was your home, wish you were never gone. Jump through the fire for me. Cross over land and sea. If you could take it, then we can make it. Why? 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 Oh, why? Why? Oh, why? How go the distance for you? How go the distance? Distance, no, no. Oh.
Yay!
Yay!
That's great.
Thank you.
So you have a couple shows coming up soon.
Yes.
The record release show.
I do.
Mm-hmm. Will you tell us where you'll be?
Yes. If you're in New York, I have a EP release show tomorrow at Baby's All Right in Brooklyn. And then in LA, I have an EP release show February 23rd at the Echo. Then I also have one in San Diego the 24th and San Francisco on March 9th. So just go to my website or something and you'll find all the dates.
Cool.
Yeah.
Well, thanks so much again for being here with us.
Thank you for having me.
Absolutely. Please come back and visit anytime.
I will.